Fire.
I command them to the abyss. Anything which is not of God.
In my life, in my body, in my career, in every sector of my life.
Catch fire now.
I command them.
Come out.
I command.
Everything to turn around for my good. Say, God Almighty, you are holy. You are wonderful. You are glorious. I love you so much. You are God of Abraham. God of Isaac. God of Jacob. I worship you. I adore you. I love you so much. Say, Lord Jesus Christ. You are my Lord. You are my Savior.
Wash me with your blood.
Forgive me my sins. Say, Lord Jesus Christ.
You are the Alpha.
The Omega.
The King of Kings.
The Lords of Lords.
Wonderful.
Counselor.
Mighty God.
Everlasting Father.
I worship you.
Say, Wonderful Holy Ghost.
I surrender to you.
I open my heart.
I open my spirit.
Teach me your word.
Reveal to me.
Your divine revelations.
In the name of Jesus.
The Bible says that where two or three comes together in my name, Jesus said that there I am in their midst. And also tonight, Jesus Christ is here, the Holy Ghost is here, God Almighty is here. We're in the presence of God and we'll have a privilege to sing unto God tonight. Let us get ready to sing unto God tonight.
In Zimbabwe, you are Alpha and Omega. We worship you, our Lord. You are worthy to be praised. Sing it again.
Also tonight you will have a privilege to go through the word of God together and the word of testimony tonight.
Amen.
Amen.
Our testimony reads as follows. Blessed with a job. There is a woman in Namibia who has testified about the goodness of God Almighty in her life. She called the man of God last year when she was looking for a job as her contract had ended. The man of God prayed for her over the phone. She has testified that she got two job offers, and she is now working and also has a business that is operating. She also had problems in her relationship. After receiving prayer, all the misunderstandings have been resolved. Things are going well in her relationship. Glory to God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Our announcements are as follows. Every morning at 6 a.m. from Monday to Friday, we have our morning prayer, which is at 7 a.m. on Saturdays and Sundays. Our midday service starts at 5 to 12. And then we have our evening service, which starts at 6 p.m. every night. Our midnight prayer starts at 5 to 12 every night. And we also have our weekly prayer and fasting, which is on Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays. The details of the fasting are shared on our different WhatsApp groups. Amen. Tonight, Amen. We will read the word of God from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 25, from verse 23 NIV. It reads as follows. When Abigail saw David, she quickly got off her donkey and bowed down before David with her face to the ground. She fell at his feet and said, "Pardon your servant, my lord, and let me speak to you. Hear what your servant has to say. Please pay no attention, my lord, to that wicked man Nabal. He is just like his name. His name means fool. A folly goes with him. And as for me, your servant, I did not see the man my lord sent. And now, my lord, as surely as the Lord your God lives, and as you live, since the Lord has kept you from bloodshed and from avenging yourself with your own hands, may your enemies and all who are intent on harming my lord be like Nabal. And let this gift which your servant has brought to my lord be given to the men who follow you. Please forgive your servant's presumption. The Lord your God will certainly make a lasting dynasty for my lord, because you fight the Lord's battles, and no wrongdoing will be found in you as long as you live. Even though someone is pursuing you to take your life, the life of my lord will be bound securely in the bundle of the living by the Lord your God. But the lives of your enemies he will hurl away as from the pocket of his sling. Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Also tonight, we will have a privilege to go through the Word of God tonight, believing the Word of God to be taught with power. Power to heal, power to bless, power to protect in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let us go through the Word of God tonight from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 25 from verse number 23. The Bible says that when Abigail saw David, she quickly got off her donkey and bowed down before David with her face to the ground. I want to help us just to catch up what was happening. The Bible is talking about, you know, David sent his man to Nabal. When he sent this man to Nabal, who was one of the rich men of the time, the Bible said that when he sent this man to go and ask for some meat, and the Bible said that when those men arrived to Nabal, the Bible said that Nabal said that, "Who is David? Who is the son of Jesse?" That means Nabal did not acknowledge David. Even though there was no way that David or anybody, that Nabal and anybody could say who is David. Because by that time, everybody knew who was David. There was nobody who did not know David. But there was a man by the name of David who have killed Goliath. Everybody knew David. There was a man by the name of David who the King Saul was after. Everybody knew David. That there is David. Who God is with. A mighty man. Who God is using by the time.
Amen.
But now, you know, Nabal was trying to provoke David and say that, who is David? Who is David? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
And the Bible said that by this time, David had favored Nabal's men. Nabal's men, they were looking after their flock close to the place where David and his men were camping. And David and his men make sure that they protected Nabal's flock.
Amen.
They favored Nabal. It was not as if they don't know who David and his men are. They know who they was. And David have taken care and have done good to the life of Nabal. But Nabal in return is asking, who is David? This time David was angry. This time David was angry. The Bible says that in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 25. The Bible said that in verse number 22, David said, may God deal with David. Be it ever so severely, if by morning I live alive, one male of all who belong to him. David was saying that if I don't deal with Nabal today and this man, may God deal with him.
Amen.
David was angry. He was ready to go and kill everybody in the house of Nabal. Because the mistake that Nabal have done was not to respect and acknowledge David.
Amen.
Then David was going out to go and deal with Nabal. And everyone who is a man in the house of Nabal. But the Bible talks about there was a woman, a wife of Nabal by the name of Abigail. When she heard what Nabal have said, how Nabal have responded to those who David have sent, the Bible said that no, she knew who David was. She went and cooked, baked cakes, prepared food. And she prepared food to go and give to David, to quench the anger of David. You know, you need some people who are able to respect. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Who are able to honor.
Amen.
Like Abigail.
Amen.
You know, Abigail, when the Bible talks about Abigail, it talks about Abigail as a woman who was wise.
Amen.
She was wise.
Amen.
She was wise in such a way she could understand the mistake and correct a mistake.
Amen.
And the Bible said that she prepared something to eat for David and his men. That's what the Bible is saying, that in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 25, verse number 23. Bible says that when Abigail saw David, she quickly get off her donkey and bow down before David with her face on the ground. She knows how to honor. She knows how to approach. She knows how to honor. She knows how to approach. You know, this woman reminds me of a woman by the name of Esther. The Bible says that Esther, in her time, when the Bible talks about there was a decree against the Jews, when that there was that decree against the Jews, which the Bible said that the Jews were said to be killed, the Jews were said to be annihilated, and Esther was a queen. The Bible said that Esther, when he was approached by Mordecai, she told herself, she told Mordecai, go and tell the Jews. Go and tell the Jews to fast, to enter into a fast, so that I can do what you are telling me to do, to stop the king from annihilating all the Jews. And the Bible says that she went on the fast. After going to the fast, the Bible says that she went and approached the king. And the Bible says that God made sure that there was a favor on Esther. Even though there was a law that nobody just approached the king. If anybody could go to the king without being invited, the Bible says that that person could be killed. But God made sure that when she approached the king, there was enough favor.
Amen.
For her life to be spared.
Amen.
And the Bible says that she invited the king to come for a banquet. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When she have invited the king for the banquet, for a dinner in her house, the Bible says that she prepares something wonderful to eat for the king. She prepares something wonderful for the king. And when the Bible says that when the king was eating, when the king was enjoying food, then she now tells their story about Haman have been plotting to kill the Jews. And the Bible says that the king was angry, and in return, instead of the Jews getting annihilated, Haman was killed. Their enemy was killed. Then I'm trying to tell you that this was the wisdom of Esther. Esther knew how to approach the king.
Amen.
Esther knew that, she knew how to clean.
Amen.
She knew how to cook.
Amen.
And enter into the heart of the king.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's something to be learned.
Amen.
That as a child of God, you must know how to approach.
Amen.
It's the same thing also when you are dealing with God.
Amen.
You must know how to approach God.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
So that you can be able to change, to get into the heart of God.
Amen.
And change the situation at hand.
Amen.
You must know how to approach.
Amen.
On the day of bad news, on the bad day when things are not going well, and you want to change the heart of God, and you want to change the mind of God, you must know how to approach God.
Amen.
You must know how to approach God. You must know how to touch the heart of God.
Amen.
For God's mind to change.
Amen.
You must know how to approach God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say fire, yeah, 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 yeah.
Fire, yeah, 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 yeah.
I love the word of God.
I love the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
You need to be the child of God with a revelation.
Amen.
Of how to get into the heart of God.
Amen.
In order to change the mind of God.
Amen.
You need to have that kind of wisdom. The Amen. Wisdom of the kind of wisdom like the wisdom of Abigail.
Amen.
Abigail prepares something to eat for David and his men. And when she arrived there, she does not talk on top of the donkey.
Amen.
She bowed down.
Amen.
And child of God, you must know how to approach God.
Amen.
There is a way to approach God.
Amen.
When we go to the book of Matthew chapter 6, the Bible says that this is Jesus Christ when he was teaching us to approach God, to walk with God, to relate with God, to talk with God, to pray. Jesus said that in the book of Matthew chapter 6, verse number 9. He says that this is then how you should pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us our daily bread. But when you realize very well, Jesus said that he starts by worshiping God. He tells you when you want to God to do something for you, you approach God. You want to talk to God, you worship God. You start by worshiping him. As you start by worshiping him, you tell him that you are our Father who art in heaven.
Amen.
Hallowed be your name.
Amen.
Your kingdom come.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You start, you approach God with worship.
Amen.
You don't just start by bombarding God by your problems. By your prayer request.
Amen.
You approach God by worship.
Amen.
Another thing that when you worship God, you don't go before God empty-handed.
Amen.
The Bible said that God have already said that you shall not appear before me what? Empty-handed. Then when you go to God, you approach him with an offering. That's why also Abigail, she has prepared something to eat to David. She's not just going there to kneel down and say, David, please don't kill my family. Please don't. He's not doing that. She's worshiping David. She's honoring David. As she's honoring David, she's bowing down. She has got something that she can present before David. And the Bible says that now she's talking to approaching David in that manner.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
One of the secret, don't approach God empty-handed.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
You have got a serious matter.
Amen.
Serious matter, you want God to intervene.
Amen.
If you've got a serious matter, you don't appear before God empty-handed.
Amen.
The Bible talks about Saul. The Bible said that when Saul was looking for the donkeys, the Bible said that he was looking for the donkeys, up and down with his servant, they could not find. And he asked his servant, what can we do? His servant said that, no, there is a man of God around here. There is a man of God here. He's a seer. But we must not go. And Saul said that we must not. Don't you have something to give the man of God? So we must not go before the man of God empty-handed. And the Bible says that when he goes to the man of God, not empty-handed, the man of God was waiting for them. And that's how he began to be a king also. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Knowing how to approach. The power of approaching.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say fire, yeah, 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 yeah.
Fire, yeah, 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 yeah.
I love the word of God.
I love the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says that in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 25, verse number 24. She fell at his feet and said, "Pardon your servant, my Lord. Let me speak to you. Hear what your servant has to say." Please pay attention, no attention, my Lord, to that wicked man Nabal. He is just like his name. His name means fool. And folly goes with him. And as for me, your servant, I did not see the man my Lord have sent.
Amen.
And now, my Lord, as surely as the Lord lives, your God lives. As you live, since the Lord has kept you from bloodshed, from avenging yourself with your own hands, may your enemies and all who are intent of harming my Lord be like Nabal. And verse number 27, and let this gift which your servant have brought to you, my Lord, be given to the men who follow you.
Amen.
And the Bible says that in verse number 28, please forgive your servant presumptions. The Lord, your God, certainly make us lastly dynasty for my Lord. Because you fight the Lord's battle, and no wrongdoing will be found in you as long as you live.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, that day, Abigail saved her family.
Amen.
That day, Abigail saved her family and saved David from wrongdoing.
Amen.
You know, we need people like this. You must be a child of God like this.
Amen.
Who will stand in a gap like an intercessor.
Amen.
Who will be able to intercess for your family.
Amen.
Who will intercess for your country.
Amen.
Who will intercess for those who are in the world.
Amen.
And stop God's wrath.
Amen.
In the day like this, when God is angry and he want to deal with maybe with your family, with your friends, with those who are close to you, but you are able to stand in a gap.
Amen.
When you have prayed properly.
Amen.
When you have approached God properly.
Amen.
And God changed his mind.
Amen.
You know, the Bible talks about how Abraham saved Lot. The Bible says that, you know, when God was angry with Sodom and Gomorrah and was sending angels to go and destroy Sodom and Gomorrah, the Bible said that Papa Abraham began to pray. When God says that Abraham is the friend of God, Abraham is my friend and I cannot hide anything from him, and he tells him that he's going to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah, the Bible says that Abraham begin to intercede for Lot.
Amen.
And say that, what about if there are 50 people who are righteous? Are you going to destroy them with those who are wicked? Until God said that, no, until he goes, even if there is one righteous man in Sodom and Gomorrah, God said that he won't destroy Sodom and Gomorrah, the righteous with the wicked.
Amen.
And God saved Lot because of the prayers of Abraham.
Amen.
I'm saying to you, child of God, your family can be saved because of you.
Amen.
Your country can be saved because of you.
Amen.
Because you know how to stand in the gap.
Amen.
Can you say, oh Holy Ghost?
Oh Holy Ghost.
Help me to intercede.
Help me to intercede.
Help me to stand in the gap.
Help me to stand in the gap.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Child of God, God have put you in that family for such a time such as this.
Amen.
God have put you in that country for such a time such as this.
Amen.
God have put you in that company for the purpose of this, so that you can be an intercessor.
Amen.
You can be an Abigail.
Amen.
Who present even offerings unto God, and your offering talks for the whole of your family.
Amen.
Who present even prayers, and your prayers talks for your country.
Amen.
And you make sure that everything turns around for your good, for the good of your family, for the good of your country.
Amen.
Because you are Christ ambassador.
Amen.
That's what the Bible says. You are Christ ambassador, a representative of God. Who God have put you strategically.
Amen.
So that you can make sure that when God moves, the plans of God can be executed well, because you can agree with God.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
Because you are an intercessor.
Amen.
The Bible said that one day God was very angry, and he wanted to wipe out all the nation of Israel as they were coming out of Egypt. But the Bible said that Moses interceded for Israel until God changed his mind and saved the nation of Israel.
Amen.
Then it was Moses, one man praying unto God, and could change God's mind. As we are seeing here, Abigail was interceding for Nabal, for the whole of his family. And because of Abigail's intercession, the whole family was saved.
Amen.
Because of you, nation can be saved.
Amen.
Because of you, God can move in your family.
Amen.
And some people may never know how wicked the devil is.
Amen.
Because there is a woman, there is a man who is standing in the gap.
Amen.
And pray until God moves.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say fire. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Fire, yeah, 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 yeah.
I love the word of God.
I love the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, the Bible says that, you know, you are the watchman.
Amen.
You are the watchman. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And as a watchman, the Bible says that in the book of Isaiah chapter 62, the Bible said that I have posted watchmen on your walls, Jerusalem. They will never be silent day or night. You who call on the Lord, give yourself no rest. Give him no rest until he establishes Jerusalem and make a praise of the earth. Then, as a child of God, you are placed strategically in your family.
Amen.
Strategically in that company.
Amen.
Strategically in that country.
Amen.
To be a watchman.
Amen.
Who must never slumber but stand in the gap in prayers.
Amen.
And stand in the gap interceding until you see the hand of God wherever you are.
Amen.
And it's until you stop the plan of the devil wherever you are.
Amen.
And you can see the glory and the grace of God.
Amen.
And sometimes you turn God from his wrath.
Amen.
You know, do you know that if it was not for you, sometimes something very bad could have happened in the country?
Amen.
Maybe in your family. But because of you, as a watchwoman, as a watchman, as you stand in the gap and you do your daily duties of prayer, you change God's mind, and God could favor that family. God could favor that country.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say fire. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Fire. Yeah, 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 yeah.
I love the word of God.
I love the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
The Bible says that in the book of Isaiah, chapter 43, verse number 4. The Bible says that since you are precious and honored in my sight because I love you, I will give people in exchange for you, nations in exchange of your life.
Amen.
Because you have gone before God and you find favor in the heart of God.
Amen.
God does not want to hurt your feelings.
Amen.
And when you have found favor in the heart of God like that, he makes sure that he protect where you are a watchman.
Amen.
He protect and bless where you are a watchwoman.
Amen.
And child of God, don't give him rest. Don't rest.
Amen.
Don't stop.
Amen.
Because through you, God can be able to move.
Amen.
God can be able to move. Imagine that day David, the way he was angry, the whole family was wiped out. The whole family was wiped out. There was not going to be the house of Nabal.
Amen.
Even though God is going to deal with Nabal in another way, which very soon you are about to see. But that day, the family of Nabal was saved because of that woman.
Amen.
But I'm saying to you, child of God, continue to be the one who stand in the gap.
Amen.
Continue to be the one who stand in the gap.
Amen.
Tonight we're about to pray, asking God, asking the Holy Spirit, help me to always stand in the gap.
Amen.
I want to see your favor in my life. You tell him, I want to see your favor in my family. I want to see your favor in my country. I want to see your favor. Give me strength never to give God rest. Give me strength to always seek you. Begin to pray. Rakita pahanta labashandalaba. Manta labaye terebeye. Honoroboshe berebe. Mandala basu kurubu, mandala bashe kerebe, mandarubu, mandala me serebe yandereriando, yandereriyandereriyandarubu, mandala baye ndarubu yeteria, mandala basa kurubu.
We say you're worth it. Mandala
Biggest prayer of the week, and we are praying and we are fasting tomorrow. The prayer points will be shared on our WhatsApp groups, and I want to say to us tonight, may God bless you. Have a blessed and a wonderful night in Jesus' name.
Bye bye, everybody. Have a blessed morning, day, and afternoon and night.
Amen. Bye bye.